So, GitHub Actions, today's topic. Actually, I want to cover GitHub Actions for the Python project, not overall. And the intention of talk is so newbie can start use of GitHub Actions rather than I'm going in a deep in a GitHub action. I will try to cover the introduction. So, in the introduction, let's start. I don't have the table of content and all those things, small slides. So you can understand the use case of the GitHub Actions and other. So if you check, okay, introduction. So what is GitHub Actions? GitHub Actions helps you to automate the tasks within your software workflow lifecycle. The statement itself says that whenever you develop your software, okay, you need a different stage of this stages where you need to do some task. Like suppose I wrote some code, I want to test it on every PR which I raised against that project. Okay, whenever some push action happens on the master branch, then I want to test that code. I want to check the quality of that code. I want to deploy that code. All those things related to the development lifecycle, we want to automate, and GitHub Action can help you related to that. So GitHub Actions are event-driven. It's the most important thing to understand the GitHub Actions. Why I am saying GitHub Actions are event-driven? Because if you check every job, if you know about the CI/CD, let's first clear the CI/CD. So in CI/CD, we run the jobs and other. If you know about the Travis, if you know about the other CI tools, even GitLab supports the CIs. So GitLab started their CI and GitHub, I think 2 years back, they started supporting their own CI, and it looks good. Rather than using a third party like a Travis, personally, I prefer to go with the GitHub Actions because it's given me a flexibility. And the event driven means the jobs are triggered on the event, on specific event. So that's why GitHub Actions are the event driven. I added a link. I'm going to give you this PDFs and other so you can check the documentations. I don't want to waste time on this. So the component, let's try to understand GitHub Actions. How's the workflow? Are there? How's job are going to write? What are the steps and other things? So if you check this diagrams of a component, so the workflow means let's understand the terms we are going to use while writing the GitHub Actions. In community also, you need to understand this because you want to ask some questions. So workflow are the simple YAML file which holds the n number of jobs for you. And in a GitHub action, you can write n number of workflows, separate workflows for the separate tasks. So if you check here, the workflows, this take this complete block as an one workflow. Okay. And in this workflow, we have the n number of jobs. So second term is a event. Event is the specific activity which triggers your job actually. Means suppose I have some job like a pre-commit check, and I want to trigger that job. So when that job should start run, okay, that will be decided by the event, and that's why GitHub Action are the event driven. After that, jobs. As you know, every CI or every means you know CI tools, okay, they have the n number of jobs, including a Jenkins, Travis, GitLab, all those. So the means you know the concept of job is similar to the other tools, same steps. Similar steps are the specific command you can say, or specific n number of commands. Those are your steps, what you want to execute or other things. The actions can be a steps, but better to call the action as a group of step which we wrapped and create the action. And this is actually important things as per me in a GitHub Actions, because the community you know in the community we contributes to the actions, we create a small actions, like suppose pre-commit. In pre-commit, what I want to install the pre-commit, and after that I want to run those pre-commits. Okay, rather than writing those two steps, I'm wrapping, someone already created an action for me, and I can use that action in a single line and dump done. So like that, the actions are too important. In a Python package, like we are using the libraries, means piece of code we separated as a package, and we are using that piece of code for our purpose. Like that, actions are, means you can contribute to the actions, you create your own actions, or use a community actions and makes your life easy. Runners. So runners are, if you ask me, it's a normal server on which you can say GitHub action applications is running, which will help to run your task on that particular server. So there are different runners. GitHub actually providing you some runners on a different platform. You can run your self-hosted runner also. The doc is available there, and the link which I pointed, which will help you definitely to understand the other things. Okay, so those are the components. Webhooks. So as I told you, the webhook events, every job going to trigger on a specific event or cron job. Okay, so those are n number of events which I took from the GitHub documentation only. And suppose if you check here, create means delete or fork or issue, everything is there. Okay, on a project, on a pull request, mainly we trigger, means most commonly use a pull request. So let's take an example of the pull request event. Every event have activities. Okay, means suppose, okay, pull request, I want to trigger my job on a specific pull request, but on what action? Okay, so the activity is important. Means suppose I open a new pull request, then my job should run. Okay, suppose someone added a comment on a pull request, then my job should means run. Suppose the pull request is assigned to some person, then my job should run. If someone add a label on that pull request, then job should run. So like that, activities help you to customize your job run, means when your job should start running. So those are the activity types. Okay, for the every, means different events, all those events, they have the activity types, and you need to follow the documentation while automating your task. So I'm giving the simple example. I try to cover the pull request so you can understand where to refer your where to refer the documents, and you need to check the activity type, and after that start automating that task. So activity type is important. After that, supported platform. Why I personally love GitHub Action, because it supports the Mac OS, and those are some supported platforms. It supports the Linux, Ubuntu platform. After that, Windows it supports the Mac OS. And note, those versions are weekly updated, and I already put a link here. So after this talk, you can check the latest supported platforms. Okay. Then some common checks. So now let's start a demo rather than wasting a time on a theory, because I want everyone should try it after the talk, and at least I can tell you how to start a GitHub Actions. After that, Google or documentation will help you definitely. So common checks for the Python project. If you check here, personally, I divide any Python project in means four different groups. I can say five different things. I divide the actions, or you can say my workflows, or you can say my jobs on a different things. First, I want to go with the code quality check for the every pull request and every push action on my main branch. Why? Because code quality is too important, and every Python project should maintain that. You can use the different things. I generally use a pre-commit for that with a placate and black and other things, other hooks. Okay, you can go with your, if you want to use only Flickit, then use Flickit or other, but code quality is the important task and better to have in your project as a part of test. Second thing, every project should have the unit test. So run the unit test. So that will be the our one job. Different platforms. Why I'm talking about a different platform, there is a story. While explaining you workflow, I will tell you why I use to run my every pull request on the different platform. After that, I always check the build of that particular package, verify that package, because some people change in a setup.py or setup.cfg, and sometime you know, the build is not proper. If you check on a PyPy, most of project their readme file not properly render on that PyPy project and all those things. Why? Because maintainer never check the package build and just push on the PyPy. Okay, don't do that. Okay, always try to first verify your package locally, after that test it on a test PyPy, and after that only deploy on your PyPy. Don't waste the space of the PyPy. It's a community driven project and you should respect it. Okay, so let's jump on. If you have any questions, let me know now, because now I'm going to go on demo, actual demo. Vishal, Bhavin, any questions?
We'll have to wait for a few seconds. There will be a delay. I will I will convey that if there are any questions. I don't think there are any questions, but if there are, we can take them at the end.
Okay, so let's go on a demo. Actually, I want to deliver the demo so people can start the GitHub action. So I created this sample project, which indirectly helping us to learn the GitHub action now. Okay, so this is a simple project, sample project, Python project, having the setup.cfg, setup.py, all those things. I have the pre-commit, all those things. And now I want to write a CI for it for the testing purpose. On every pull request, I want to do some checks. And every push on a master branch, I want to do some checks. I want to deploy it with the help of my CI only after adding a tag. And let's try to automate this repo. You can say a simple Python package. Okay, so for this, in your whenever you open any repo on a GitHub, you can check here action tabs now. Okay, and those are the old checks. Okay, ignore those. Okay, you will get new things here. So in action tabs, you can check your workflows and all those things. Okay, those are old. Now we are going to add. I already cleaned the workflows. Okay, I don't have the workflows. So let's clone this repo. Okay. So if you go on this repo, so while can I increase my font? Okay. So while writing the GitHub action, you need to do the two things. One, creating the workflow. Where to create a workflow? You need to create a one directory that is the .github under your repository, and after that, in that directory, you need to create one more folder, that is the workflow. And under that workflow, you need to write your YAML files. Those YAML files will be your workflows, different workflows. So already I created some workflows for you, and try to just I'm moving that in this directory. So if you check here now in a workflows, okay, we have some workflows, and I'm going to explain you how those workflows are there, okay. But I created it to reduce our time rather than writing it here one by one, okay. So what is the task? You need to create a .github workflows, and in this path you need to write your YAML files, which will be help you to automate your things, okay. So we are going to do the testsuite.yaml first check for the our the PR check task. So in GitHub, so those are the workflow, and we are going to check this workflow, okay. Take the example of this. Let me increase the font size if possible. Where is settings? Settings. Appearance. 20. Sorry, I apply actually. Yes, sir. Editor. $25 is okay. Okay, so this is one workflow which we have started writing now. .yaml. I created. You can create with any name. So I give the name test suite. Okay, but it's not depend the name of that workflow. It's not depend on that. You need to mention that name. So I'm giving the name of that workflow is a test suite. So the YAML tags, simple YAML syntax followed by the GitHub actions, and you need to write such YAMLs. Okay, now there is one keyword that is the on. It's a two important thing. Why? Because this workflow or the jobs are going to follow this. Okay, on with GitHub event, you want to run this workflow. Okay, and if you check here, I already told you the events, different events. So those are the events, and we are writing on which, on pull push and on pull request. Okay, we are going to run this workflow. So that's the meaning of this. Okay, so on push, but where? On specific branch. Suppose I want to run on the main vein. So when something push on the main branch, I want to run this workflow. When someone writes a pull request against main branch, and the type of that pull request is open, reopen, or synchronize, then only run my workflow, otherwise don't run. So this is the activity on which our workflow will start running. So this is the important task, means when to run your workflow. So you can define in this way in a GitHub actions. After that, like every other CI, we write start writing a jobs. So jobs is the tag in which we are going to start writing a jobs. So let's start a first job, okay. I want to do my code quality checks, and I want to pre-commit as on a one job, okay. So this is the tag name, okay. But if you don't, but I'm going to override the name. I want a good name. That's why I write like a pre-commit, okay. So if you miss this, then it will take your tag name as a, while showing in that action tabs. So better to use a better name. After that, run on which server, which platform. So pre-commit, I don't want to test it on a cross platform. Better to use it on the Linux or other only. It's okay for the Python project. So I'm running it on Ubuntu latest, okay. There are also the things. Let me show. No, I think I have availability. So try to use a Linux, because the minutes multiplier is 1. If you use the Mac OS, it's a 10. If you use a Windows, it's a 2. So try to use a Linux. And those, actually, we shall point out this before in our discussions. And it's too important information. So you can go. It will be available on my PDF. But just I'm referring you. Okay. So let's check. So I'm running it on Ubuntu latest. And after that, steps for this particular jobs. So steps, in the steps, first steps I'm writing here like a checkout. So what checkout? And I'm using the action checkout. So let's think, if you want to take info about those actions, okay, just to Google it. I need to take the info related to this act. Okay.
Nikhil, your voice is a bit breaking. So
actually, my internet was low. I think now it's okay.
I think it is okay. Maybe you can explain that V2 checkout thing again. Yeah.
Okay. 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 So if you check here, the first step is a checkout. Checkout, I'm using a checkout. Checkout means checkout to that particular code. Or whenever you raise your pull request, you want to check out on that particular branch. And after that, install that things and check something. Okay. So checkout actions help you to do that. And we are using action here, the use tag. Use some action. Okay. So while using any action, okay, check the documentation. If you search on Google, you will get the things. Okay, so checkout action, and it's a version V2. Version V2 means it's a tag. Okay, which tag are there? Always use the stable tags. Okay, so V2 is the stable one, and we are using, and it will provide you overall documentation. You know, the checkout action, and you can use a with tag also. You can specify the repository, reference, tokens, SSH key, all those things. Okay, we don't need it, but better to check the usage of that action before using in your workflow. Okay, so this is how you can start writing your GitHub actions and GitHub workflows. And the actions, how to check actions, just search it on Google. You will get the information related to the action before you use it in your workflows. Okay. And then now I check out to my code. Now I need to set up my Python, because to run the pre-commit, we are not using an action of pre-commit here. We are doing it manually. So try to avoid use the action, third-party action directly, if you are comfortable by writing your own steps. So let's check out to your Python. So to check out your Python, we have the most important action, that is the setup Python. Okay, it will help you to set up your Python. Okay, so if you check here, it will help you to set up your Python. It supports the different type of Pythons in your things, and you can use a matrix strategy or other to parameterize those Pythons. We have the example of that. And I will cover it. But this is how you need to check the actions. There are separate things which available, to specify the strategies or other things. And the every action has their own documentation. Always refer that documentation. Okay. So we are doing the setup our Python. So what this step will do, set up the Python on that particular runner for you. So here with I am mentioning Python version, I require the specific Python version, then I can specify the Python version. Like I want, suppose 3.8, then it will set up the 3.8. But if I go for 3.x, it will take the latest third Python. Means if I'm not wrong, it will take 3.9. We will check in a log. And you can specify your architecture also. But this is the limited use case. You can do a lot of things if you refer the documentation for this action, setup Python. After that, let's write our custom step, that is the pre-commit. So the run tag. run tag will help you to run your shell commands here. Okay. Now with the run tag, same YAML syntax. I want n number of steps. That's why I use a pipe here. So Python hyphen m pip install pip. I install the pip and upgrade it on the latest. After that, I install the pre-commit and run the pre-commit. So this is the steps which will do the pre-commit quality check for us. And after that, if this pre-commit is a fail, then on failure means if there is a conditional tag, if above step is fail, then show me a git dip. Otherwise, don't show me a git dip. So this is our first workflow, first job. Let me comment out the other and let's check it how it's look on a GitHub. Okay, so so let me comment it. I put S. Okay. So I'm pushing that change. So if you go here, let's create the pull request now. So I'm covering only first job now. Create pull request. So if you check now, the check for the ability and our job is started. Okay, this is how you will get a look for your jobs. Test suit, the test suit, this name is coming from this one. This is the workflow name. And after that, the pre-commit, this name is your job name. Okay, so this is the pre-commit in your job name. If you want to check, click on the details. So if you check in a test suit workflow, okay, the first job is a pre-commit. What it do, it follows our step. It set up the job, which is a GitHub actions help, means, you know, step. After that, it's checkout for you, which we wrote, mentioned in our job. After that, it set up Python. We use a 3.x, that's why it set up the 3.9 as a, means, you know, Python version. After that, it do our pre-commit things. It's render, means render the Python imports, fire-grade, lag, flake-it, all those things which mentioned in a pre-commit hook file. And after that, it's not fail. That's why git analysis, it's drop. It's drop these steps, means analysis step, because the above step is not fail. It's a success. And after that, debug statement, and after that post checkout and complete the job. So this is how you can start writing your jobs. So this is our first job, the pre-commit thing, and let's try to you know, fail this job. Let me fail this job. Suppose in this file, if I remove the end statement, it should fail, I think. So I added one error. So pre-commit should fail. Let's check. So job started running. The font is visible to you, right? Let me increase it.
Yeah, maybe increase a bit more.
Okay.
Yeah, should be fine.
Okay, so see, it's pre-commit fail, and the pre-commit fail, that's why this step failed. Now the analysis step activated because it's failed, and it's showing me no new line at the end of file. So git dip is always good. I always use, I recommend it to use, but it's depend on you. You want to use it or not. I always try to use a git dip after my pre-commit failure. So the user should know where we means directly on a CI, okay, this is missing, I need to fix it, rather than running locally the pre-commit and check it. Okay, so the this steps is always helps to me, and I always add. So this is our first job. Let's go for the other jobs and understand workflow at the same time, because now you understand how we start writing a jobs. Okay, so the pre-commit was our first job. Now let's now I want to run my unit test on this with the help of PyTest. Okay, the setup and all those things I already did it for you for the testing purpose. So I'm going to explain only job. So here the name of that job will be unit test means dash python dash matrix.python version. From where it's coming, I'm going to cover it, this variable. This is how you can write your variables in GitHub Actions. Okay, and second tag is a need. So this tag helps you to manage your flow of your jobs. Means after pre-commit success only, I want to run this job. Otherwise, don't run this job. Means the user should clear first my pre-commit things, and after that he can start executing other things, means cover the other things. Otherwise, if pre-commit is failing, no need to run this job. So that's why we added the tag like a needs. Okay, and we give the tag name of that particular job. Suppose this is the tag name pre-commit, so we are using that tag name and mention in a needs. So this job will run after pre-commit success only, means that job, pre-commit job. Otherwise it will not, it will skip. Then run on, same run on which platform you want to run, it's depend upon you. Okay, the strategy, it's two important thing which required in a Python project mainly. It will be helpful. Okay, so matrix strategies are there. Okay, which help you to parameterize the thing on a different variables or atoms, you can say. So I, with the help of matrix strategy, what I'm doing, okay, here I'm trying to parameterize my this job, this unit test job, over different Python versions. I want to check it on a PyPy3. I want to check it on Py 3.6 to 3.8. 3.9, I think it started supporting. I think it started supporting, but even devil versions, you can do the things. There is one action which is written by, I miss the name of that person, but he wrote which are on devil branches of the Python, which will support you to test. And the action name is, I think, a dead snake. Okay. So you can use that action for the upcoming versions of the Python if you want to test your package, because some packages are too important, like you can say setup tools or other those package which always needs to test against upcoming Python versions, and you can use that action. After that, steps. So for the unit test, I'm trying to cover the steps. Same, I want to check out on that particular code. After that, I want to set up my Python version. And while setting Python version, okay, I'm using the same action, but here I'm passing as a variable which I parameterize with a matrix strategy. Okay, matrix.python version. So it will iterate over this list, and it will set up the things, means parameterize the Python version for me. After this, unit test same, install setup tools and all those things, run your install your package. Suppose I'm installing it at table mode with a test, means some extra dependencies, and after that I'm running it, running the pi test. After that I'm running it with a code coverage, so I want to upload that code coverage. And for the code coverage, we have the one action, means community actions. You can use it directly, code curve, and it will upload your code coverage on the code curve. So this is how we are going to test the unit test. This is how I test the unit test. You can change your workflow, but I'm just trying how you can write your workflows. Okay. After that, platform is the one more job which I generally add in my workflows. Why I'm adding a platform? The thing was, I remember one of my package was able to install properly on Linux, as I regularly use a Linux, but it was not able to install on the Windows. And from that time, I started adding platform checks. So at least installation, it should check for me on every GitHub pull request. So someone should not do bad things with my package, and it should be installable on all the platforms. Okay. So for this, I need a unit test job, means after passing unit test job, only check for the platforms. So here, if you check here in above job, we use the matrix strategy and try to parameterize on a different Python version. But here we use the matrix strategy and with the OS name, okay, and we try to parameterize on different platforms, okay, and same variable we are using here runs on matrix.os. So it will parameterize, or it will start running on a different platform. Okay. Then steps, same steps, and the check is while checking the, means it's do the devil setup and try to do the smoke test on the platform. Smoke test means I try to import some important functions and check it's properly worked, means, you know, properly installed on that particular platform or not. Okay. So this is how I check my platform, means it's properly installed or not. And it's an important step for me. It's depend upon you. You want to adopt this, you can change and twist. After that, package. It's also important thing. Personally, I thought every time you should check, you should build your package and check it's properly rendered or not. Okay, at least with a twist. So if you check the steps here, what I'm doing, with the twin, okay, I'm checking only I'm checking it's properly, you know, twin checks. I'm doing only twin checks, and if it's passed, means okay, my package is applicable to apply, means upload on a PyPI. Otherwise, I should fix that warnings or the errors. So this is how I wrote my personal workflows for the Python packages. Okay, so this is the test suite. Let's upload it and check the jobs, how it's done. So test, which I'm going to fix it. Get status, get at dot get the workflows, test suite dot yaml. Let's comment it, get push origin action. So I've pushed all the changes, all that workflow, complete workflow. And let's check. So complete file I uploaded. Okay, let's check the details. So meanwhile, you can ask the questions, because it will take some time to run complete workflow. If you have a question, you can add. Bhavin, please let me know if someone asks any questions.
Do you want to go through some questions?
Yes.
Yeah, so let me switch to my screen. You can check the Jitsi there. So I will just switch to questions there.
Sure.
Cool. So, Tejas asks, can you explain more about the runners?
Okay. So normally runners are the things, servers on which GitHub action server GitHub action application. There is one application which is installed on that server. GitHub provided the servers with a different platforms. You can say Mac and others. Okay. Actually, those are the containers. Okay. And you can go with a self-hosted servers also if you want to use your personal servers. Especially you need when you need a nested virtualization like things, because I started using a GitHub action for nested server virtualization, but later I know that it's not supporting a nested virtualization. So those are the servers, runners, and those are normal server machines on which your actions, I mean, workflows are running. I hope this helps.
Yeah, so for different, I wanted to add something to this. So okay. For in case of macOS, those are probably from some website or some vendor called Mac Farm or something.
Right.
For Windows and Linux, those are VMs from Azure, and probably they will have some isolation, right? Like you said. So runner is basically a software which is running on that VM and which is communicating to GitHub, and together you can call that whole VM or machine as runner for your jobs. Yep. Next question is, do we need to bundle GitHub workflows also along with the code when we create PyPI package?
It's not required. Actually, it's for the it's for your testing purpose, not as a part of package. I will try to avoid it.
So is it like you will ignore those files, right? From
yes, you can ignore those files. It's depend upon your settings, how you include those files in your package. Okay. Means which file you want to include. Like some people's avoid the readmes and other along with a package like that you can include.
Got it. Okay. Next is how we can test our code with different versions of Python using GitHub workflows. That is covered, I guess, right, Nikhil?
Right. We covered. We use matrix strategy, and we try to parameterize it over the different Python versions, at least for the test, not for the other jobs like a pre-commit and other. I don't think it's need to run on the specific Python version, but test should be run on the different Python version. If you are, hosting your own Python package, it should check the support of the different Python versions.
Right. Yeah. So, next question is, what else can be written for runs on Ubuntu Lattice? So I guess you showed that in the beginning, but right. I also wanted to open that link here, right? So that everyone just gets what is supported.
Right.
So let me just open, hope it is visible. So these are basically supported values. So as you can see, there are Windows-Latest, then what else? Windows-Latest, Ubuntu-Latest, Ubuntu 14.04 and all. So Mac OS 11, Mac OS Latest. Yeah. So this should answer the question, I guess.
Right.
Okay, I guess. Okay, let me check if there are any other questions. If not, then we can continue with the demo.
Okay.
Nope, I guess.
Even I think I took 11, it's 11:51. If I want, I can go for again 20 minutes. Otherwise, I will try to wind up early. So it's depend upon the interest. People's are interested. I can go for the some bots examples and other.
Okay, so you have them ready, right?
Yes, we can go. I try to explain the workflows rather than running them, so people can try it and they should know the source.
Yeah, let's ask everyone, the audience, if you want to know about the further examples, please post yes or plus one or something in the chat. And if there are one or two plus ones, we can continue for like 10 minutes or so. That should be fine, right, Nikhil?
Yes.
You can cover the examples at
least. Yes, yes.
Yeah. let's wait because there is a delay. Yeah, while we wait, I also wanted to chat about the metrics thing, right? There in the workflows.
Yes.
So we can also kind of do the M by N, right? Ubuntu OS, Python. Right, right.
We can use a metric strategy with a different means. At the same time, you can use a metric strategy over the OS, over the Python versions. Sometime I remember one of my one thing, you know, one workflow where I use a different Python version, different OS with a different browsers.
Okay, for kind of tests, right?
For the test test script. So
headless browsers.
Right.
Yeah. Even I, if I remember, what I did was I added some container images in metrics and I ran my tests again those containers while in the CI steps. So yeah, I tried that as well.
Right. GitHub Actions, yeah, it is too flexible. Mm-hmm. That's why I love GitHub Actions than other tools. I'm not saying I'm loving you means I'm not forcing you use a GitHub Action, but it's flexible. So it's good.
Yep. Yeah, a lot of people want to know the other use cases as well. So let's go for it.
Okay.
I will switch to your screen. Right. Maybe you will also want to show your demo, right? Which you actually ran.
Okay.
So yeah, continue.
So if you check, this is the test suit workflow, which we run. And the pre-commit job was there. After that, four jobs run for the unit test. And after that, after the completion of that job, build and verify package job runs. Okay. After that, parallelly, some metrics job runs. You can limit your jobs. It's possible to limit your job at the at the same time how many jobs should run parallelly. So it's also possible. There is a tag. Okay, you need to refer the documentation. GitHub Action provides you a lot of things. Okay, but I try to cover on the initial level how you can write your workflows for the Python package specially, and the best things which you can do. Okay, so if you check here, jobs, now the unit test is run over Python 3.6. Okay, the setup Python, after that, it's do the step for the unit test. And you can check 100%, it's passing. After that, it's uploaded the code coverage for you. And you can check it like here. So if you check here, so it's code.io, it's uploaded. After that, you can build and verify the package, which is also successful, all those things. So this is how you can write your workflow. And this is the jobs which you I try to cover in my workflow while writing the Python package specially. Okay. After that, I always try to, merge this. No, I want to include one more job. Okay, after that we'll merge. Okay, if you check this, this is how we completed test suite. And let's go for one more thing, deploy. Okay, so this is the deploy.py. This, you know, now I want to release the Python package on the PyPy, and for that I use the always tagging. With the tag I want to run. So while publishing on a Python PyPy, how I use this is the examples on push on a main branch, but with a tag. If I add some tag on a main branch, then only run my this workflow. Okay, and what its workflow doing, its name is build and publish the package Python package distribution on the PyPy, and run only if, okay, the GitHub event.rip runs start with the tags. This is the hack, and this is actually provided by one of the maintainer of GH Action PyPy publish. So it's a valid thing. Okay, you can use it. Okay, and I'm regularly using. Runs on Ubuntu latest, and after that, check out all those things I set up. With the twins, I check the package first, okay, and after that the last, which is important, deploy on a Python PyPy, and we are using this action for deploying things. You can write your custom things also if you want to add your token as a secret and other things. Okay. So if you go on this action, let's go on this action. Okay, so if you check the minimal requirement, user and the secret for the your PyPy API token. PyPy API token, how you can create, if you know, if you are maintaining Python package on the PyPy, you can create it easily. Can I show you? Maybe, let's check.
I guess you can go to the secret section.
Actually, I'm trying. Yeah. Right, right. Secret section.
Yeah, that
would. But how to create a token? That's there. Also, good. You know, good practice is always try to use project level means your token rather than overall.
Yeah, you might want to do the login and all on a different screen.
Right. No problems.
Okay.
So let's take an example of any means you know the package. So if you go on account settings, so if you check API tokens here, you can add a new API token for the separate projects, and you can create your API token for that. Copy that. It shows one time only, and you need to put that token in your settings. So GitHub provides some secrets management in a secret settings. In a secret, you can create your new token, means add a secret, new secret. Okay, give the name and add your value which you have created, and it will start working for you. So this is how you can set the secret, okay, for your project. Let's jump on the things. Okay, so the PyPy token is coming from that. Okay, what we created now means I show you how to create as a password, and here repository, I'm trying to use this test repository rather than publishing on a PyPy. Don't upload, means your test package don't upload on a PyPy. Okay, I'm strictly means I'm saying it strictly, because don't waste the resources. Okay, the test PyPy means clean up the projects after some time. So always use test PyPy for the testing, and if you are ready with your package properly, then only upload to the PyPy. Okay, so let's include this workflow also. GitHub workflow deploy. Okay, so this is what code coverage bot also added. It's running, and I don't want to run these things now. Let's merge this because I have less time. Okay, so now that job is part of this. Let's try to add the tag. I don't know it will work or not because I won't tested it. I'm trying it directly in front of you. Let's add a new release. Suppose give the tag 0.01. Sorry, 01 only. Sorry, 02. Give the 0.02. Suppose something test tag. Okay, publish it. So if you check now actions, it should start trigger publish PyPy. Okay, so it started. Okay, Let's wait. So it's building a package now and it's checking with the twins that package is proper or not. Okay, now started deploying. Okay. Successfully, no, deployment fail. I never tested it because some problem. File name already has been used. I used a different version. Actually, I think same version I added. Let's check that name on PyPy. What version is available? What was the package name? I think test gh action. GH action 0.02 turn.
Does someone else own it?
I think. I just tried because I'm showing the how you can do the right. things. Right. But if you want to, just showing how workflow is going to work. And yeah. So, sorry, I don't have someone else owning back. Okay. But this is how you can, I want to pass message like this is how you can push your packages on a PyPy. Just after successful checks, you remove this repository. Repository URL, so it will automatically take the actually pypy.org, not a test pypy.org. Okay, so this is how you can deploy your packages, Python packages. Okay, after that, let's move on some writing some bots type thing. Okay, so if you remember, pre-commit hook always updated, and we need to always do it manually. Pre-commit auto upgrade, and after that we just need to commit and raise one separate PR. Okay, it's a hectic task. Some bot is already available now to do this. Okay, but we are trying to solve it manually with the help of GitHub Actions. So this is how workflow. So I'm not better to schedule that job on every day on some time, but for show you how it's going to work. Okay, I'm going to use event push only, so instantly it start the run. Okay, what it's the steps are doing: setting the Python version, installing the pre-commit, and what thing is rule, pre-commit auto upgrade. Okay, I'm using one action which will create the pull request for you. Okay, and in this pull request I'm adding the title like update pre-commit hook, pre-commit means commit message and body. Okay, and with that changes I try to upload that. This GitHub token is a predefined thing. It's provided by the GitHub only. You don't need to mention in secrets. Okay, it's already available secret for your repo. Okay, so this is how we will try. Let's try it. So get checkout master. Sorry, man. Okay. Some conflict is there. Contract file and deleted by us deploy. Okay. No problem. Unresolved complex.
Yeah, just do
in a deep layer.
No, so basically that file was not there, I guess, and then we created it, right?
Right. We just copy paste it.
Okay. Then maybe you can just git add that file, or git rm, anything that works.
Let's add this dot git. What we want? GitHub workflows pre-commit auto update. Okay. Now,
but the deploy still needs to be taken care of. That's why it is failing. So you can just do git.
Remove it.
Yeah, you just remove it, right? Git rm. We will have to do git rm, I guess.
Will not go at all. Okay. So we are with commit. Let's commit like a pre commit bot. Okay. And let's try to push new pull request with the branch pre bot. Okay, so if whenever I will write this, so create one pull request, and if you check here, now we are using a push event, okay, so it should trigger immediately, okay. So let's create pull request, okay. So if you check our means, you know, workflow will start on a push and a pull request, and I'm expecting one separate MR from it. Yep. So what this MR is doing, okay, actually the workflow is trying to update my pre-commit config hooks, okay, and if I run it on a cron things, means on schedule it on specific time, then regularly it will check for my pre-commit hooks and raise the PR for me on my repo. So this is how you can start writing your bots with the help of schedule and other things of GitHub Actions. So this is how you can solve the things for the pre-commit hook update. There are other examples also. There is one more example, I think, which one I already, we saw it for the Python Pune, I think. So the jobs which create an issue and send notification to the IRC, which we want. And this is how that job creates the separate issue, like a September. It's an old thing, which is in my slides. This is how it's opened the new issue, which is created by the GGS actions, and it's a Telegram message which is breached already. Let me show that what Python Pune meetup newsletter. So this is the newsletter issue. This is the bot, and bot, it's run on UTC on every first day of the month. Okay. And what is doing? It's fetching the addition. It's create the addition. Okay. Date. After that, it's use create issue is the one action which help us to create a new issue on the particular repo, and it's you taken the GitHub token only. Okay. The file issue template. We have the issue template. We are using it. Okay. It's writes the overrides the variables. And after that, there is one more action, the IRC message action, which we use to send our message to the IRC channel. And IRC channel is bridged with our Telegram channel. So that's why that message appears on the Telegram also. So this is how we automate our steps, and you can automate your own steps. So thanks. Any questions? Now I need to stop, I think. One minute. I want to tell you, I'm going to add this link on my GitHub, you know.
Yeah, you can add on the your proposal.
Right. And yeah, the presentation, right. Presentation is available here only in a Beamer class. The ghaction.pdf. Okay. In same repo, all the things are available. The workflows already I push. I'm going to push merge this workflow also. The bot actually. So you can refer those workflows and you can use those in your things. You can change it as per you. Okay.
And yeah, you are merging it live.
Yep. Done.
Yeah. Yep. Okay. So there is one question, I guess. I will switch over to it and then we can conclude.
Sure.
My screen should be visible to you. So there was a question that can we import GitHub workflows into GitLab?
No.
Right. So directly you can't, but there is some tool called ACT, A-C-T, which basically says you can, let me just open it, right? So I am just guessing here. I don't know if it will work or not at all. I'm just...
Because why I think it will not miss normal workflows we can import, but the actions which we do always, okay, right. It's not possible. I don't think it's work fine.
Yeah. I mean, we don't know, right, if it will work or not.
Right.
So there is this tool called ACT, which helps you to run the GitHub actions locally. So okay. I'm not sure if it will work or not. Someone will have to try it and tell us.
Right. And tell us on our channel also your experience, how it's worked.
Yeah. Right. There was one more thing, Nikhil, which came across, Vishal wanted to share. So there is this marketplace for GitHub actions. So you can basically look for official actions from companies. So like you can see your Docker login. There is something from Lightstep, something from Amazon. So these are the verified ones. So also you can get other actions.
Here. Marketplace? Right. As Bhavin told, a marketplace is a place where the community contributes different actions. And those are predefined steps you can easily use in your workflows and makes life easy.
Like the one we use, right? For IRC, for creating pull request and all.
Right.
Cool. That's it, I guess, for Nikhil's talk. Yep. Thank you, Nikhil. It was a really great discussion. And all the PDF and all will be available.
In that repo only.
Yeah.
I added a link.